that matters every single day. Eddie's podcast is here to show you the way. He presents some opinions and interesting views. He even has Jacquie on to discuss the news. It's Eddie's podcast.
They've been waiting to see you. Loyalty means everything to the clones. Surely you have felt it. The dark side has never been stronger. Every choice you have made has led you to this moment.
So to introduce a new feature on this week's Eddie podcast, I've invited my favorite Star Wars fan, Jacquie Segment, to join us. Hey, Jacquie, are you here?
Hi, Eddie. How are you tonight?
I am fantastic. And I brought you on our show to talk about a new development that's going on in the Star Wars universe, specifically what's happening in the cartoon series The Clone Wars. One of our favorite Star Wars characters is back.
Well, it's notable that The Clone Wars are back because for so long that last season went unfinished. So it's kind of a gift that it's being finished, number one, that they're finishing Ahsoka's arc and that it's so beautiful. I mean, the differences in the cartoon from when it first came out to now, you can't even measure how much better the cartoon looks now.
Now, if you're just watching and you've only seen the movies, you have no idea who Ahsoka Tano is or who we're talking about. Can you give a brief description of the character?
Ahsoka Tano is a former Jedi Padawan. And to many people's surprise, she was the Padawan of Anakin Skywalker. So for people like me who grew up with the original three movies and maybe weren't as into the prequels or maybe didn't watch the prequels at all, all you know is that it kind of tells the story of Anakin Skywalker who becomes Darth Vader at the end. We all know who Darth Vader is and what he does. And I had no idea that this cartoon was even out there. I knew the prequels were out there, but I just couldn't even.
So Ahsoka wasn't in the original Star Wars movies, but Lucasfilm put out something called The Clone Wars in the early 2010s.
Yeah, late aughts, early 2010s. It was a cartoon and it introduced some new characters like Ahsoka, or it kind of broadened it on the existing characters. Anakin is much more fully fleshed out. His relationship with Padme is, you know, you kind of get the idea it's really not that big of a secret, but that people are just letting it go. There's a lot of things that happen in Clone Wars that people who saw the movies wouldn't understand completely just in a vacuum. But basically what it is that in the cartoons, which take place during the Clone Wars, Anakin is assigned a Padawan, a young Jedi learner. And that's Ahsoka Tano. And she goes with Anakin and Obi-Wan and R2-D2 and C-3PO on many of their adventures, especially has a good relationship with R2-D2. She can talk to all of the droids. But in retrospect, she fits into the history very, very well, because as we know, one of the reasons that Anakin turned to the dark side is because he could not be unattached to people he loved. He loved people deeply and fully, and he could not be unattached. We obviously saw that in the movies with Padme. What we see in the Clone Wars is how that also extends out to his Jedi family, especially to Ahsoka. Their relationship has lots of bumps to it, and there's a termination of their relationship at one point, and it clearly changes him. So it helps flesh out that part of Anakin that some of us might have thought was too big a jump from him being just this somewhat disaffected Jedi to, oh my God, he's Darth Vader. This makes the story a little more complete. So Ahsoka is really an important character, you know, depending on how far you want to go in canon.
And speaking of canon, Disney bought the Star Wars rights after the Clone Wars, or pretty much as the Clone Wars were occurring, and they shut it down.
Was not finished because that, right, that's why Clone Wars was not finished, because Disney bought it. At the time, it was on one of Disney's rival networks, so they just shut it down, and it wasn't until they saw how popular it got that they decided to go ahead and finish it.
So are the stories that happened before Disney acquiring Lucasfilm, is that considered canon for Star Wars?
Fully canonized. It's all a part of canon. Ahsoka is a canon character, as is Rex, who we only kind of briefly see in the movies, but he's a real full-fledged character in the Clone Wars cartoons.
And there's a decade between the release of season 6 and season 7 now because of the way they've done this.
That's accurate. But I think that they're finding, I haven't actually looked at any of the statistics, I've just read a couple of generalized articles, that this is just incredibly popular. Kind of coming on the heels of The Mandalorian, also Ahsoka's arcs tend to tie into Mandalore and Mandalorian history. So it's all worked in beautifully, of course, well planned. And it's come at a time where people need something to watch. And I think it's incredibly popular. And I think it's as popular or more popular than they anticipated.
And rumor has it, Ahsoka is going to be a live action character in season 2 of The Mandalorian. Is that, I keep hearing that, and I keep hearing Rosaria Dawson's the person being casted, but I don't know if there's been an official announcement. Is that just rumors?
She hasn't admitted to it. Disney has not admitted to it, but everybody else seems to think it's going to happen. And you know how these contracts can go. So if it's true, she may just not be able to say anything yet. She is suggested for the character. She has been for a long time. She's roughly the age that Ahsoka would be during The Mandalorian. Ahsoka has a lot of history with Mandalore. So she would be a natural fit for the show.
And we're going to take a break right now and watch a clip of the badassery of Ahsoka.
The transmission log. Let's find out where you are. Mandalore. What's Maul doing there?
I knew you were no petty smuggler. Who are you?
So is this why Ahsoka is one of your favorite Disney Star Wars characters?
Yeah, I mean, she is one of my favorite characters. She has literally grown up in front of our eyes. She has developed some really amazing, deep and complex relationships. She's just a really incredible fighter, and she knows, you know, something about everything, it seems. and she has that Jedi do-gooder about her. She's a lot of fun, and she's also a little disaffected with the Jedi, but for different reasons. Another thing she and Anakin have in common.
So one thing I find really fascinating are the different fighting styles from the various villains and heroes in Star Wars. For example, Rey has a very similar sword fighting style to Palpatine. Ahsoka has an extremely specific style of sword fighting with her two lightsabers. Do you see any comparisons with her style with any other Star Wars character?
I think it's pretty unique, in part because, you know, so many of the Star Wars fighting styles come from live characters. Ahsoka's comes from cartoons. So it's actually going to be kind of interesting to see how they translate it into live action. She has a very athletic gymnastic style, and it's not that she has a double-sided blade. She uses two blades, so she's ambidextrous with them. And I would say she's got a pretty unique fighting style.
Well, we know that Ahsoka is in episodes 7, 8, and 9 of this season's Clone Wars, and we haven't talked specifically about those episodes because we want them to get out and we don't want to spoil anything. But Jacquie, I wanted to thank you for joining us on Eddie's podcast, and we look forward to delving deeper into some geekier Star Wars and other issues with you in the near future.
Bye.
I love you.
You should. Do something that matters.
Trauma, you've been through it. Something like closure to promise to get through it. Sometimes it's nice to lean on somebody's shoulder, especially when that shoulder been there a couple times over. That intimacy navigates and empathy. Eddie's podcast, a journey, relax and take a seat. La-da-da-do. Do something that matters. La-da-da-do. Do something that matters. Welcome to the Eddie Podcast.